Good evening. Welcome to We Are All Part of the Same Dream. Somos parte del mismo sueño. Welcome this evening and thank you for being here as we prepare to get started to continue the celebration of the ideals of Martin Luther King, the vision of so many people here. Just wanted to remind everybody, it seems like we just think that MLK was the only person that changed this world. And what we know is there's so many of you in this room that helped change this great nation to a better, more inclusive nation of respect. And I personally and the board would like to thank you. At this time, could we have the color guard, please? Ladies and gentlemen, I pledge allegiance of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. You may be seated. Mr. Jordan Sanders, please.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we're going to begin our program. We are going to have Jordan Sanders come up, and he is going to sing Lift Every Voice and Sing. And for the singing of this hymn and anthem, I'm going to ask us again to please stand.
Lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven ring, ring with the harmonies of liberty. Let our rejoicing as the listening skies, let it resound loud as the rolling sea. Sing a song full of the faith that the dark past has taught us. Sing a song full of the hope that the present has brought us. Facing the rising sun of our new day begun, let us march on to victory is won. Stony the road we trod, bitter the chastening rod, felt in the days when hope unborn had died, yet with a steady beat, have not our weary feet come to the place for which our Father sighed. We have come over a way that with tears have been watered. We have come treading our path through the blood of the slaughtered, out from the gloomy past, till now we stand at last where the white gleam of our bright star is cast. God of our wearies, God of our silent tears, though who has brought us thus far on the way, thou who hast by thy might led us into the light, keep us forever in the path, we pray, lest our feet stray from the places our God where we meet thee, lest our heart drunk with the wine of the world we forget thee, shadowed beneath thy hand, may we forever stand true to our God, true to our native land.
Thank you.
For the invocation and the blessing of the food, Reverend Tillis, could you do us the honor, sir? Oh, here we go.
Maybe bow heads. Most gracious and everlasting Father, we come tonight first of all telling you thank you. Thanking you for life, we thank you for health, and we thank you for strength. We thank you, O Heavenly Father, that we can say tonight that you have brought us from a mighty long way. Brought us from the outhouse into the White House. Lord, we tell you thank you for that. Thank you for what you're even doing on this evening, that you brought us together once again. You have kept us another year, and we tell you thank you for that. Thank you for the honorees. Thank you for the vision of this house on tonight. We thank you for all those that are here tonight. If you will bless this food that we're about to receive on tonight, let it be nourishment for our body. In Jesus Christ's name we do pray. Amen.
Okay, you may be seated. You may be seated. All right, we still have a few people who are on their way in, but we are going to go ahead and proceed with the program. I'm Judge Charles Williams, and I want to welcome all of you again to our Humanitarian Awards Banquet. I want to thank all of you for coming. I want to thank Manatee Educational Television for filming this event. They are of such a service to this event. They were one of the first people to really, really partner with us in this effort. At this time, I would like to call forward Vice Mayor Tambra Varnador, is she present, I believe? And she is going to give the official welcome and proclamation.
everyone. It's a pleasure to be here tonight. It's great to come out to this community every year, and it brings such a wide variety of people together, and it's great to be here tonight to honor Dr. Martin Luther King. I'm going to read a proclamation from the city of Palmetto. Whereas Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. was the most important leader of the civil rights movement in the United States, and under his leadership, historic reforms were made, and whereas he was committed to his vision of a society where color did not matter, he believed his vision was important enough to die for, and he put his life on the line every day to make this great country a vibrant, multiracial nation united in justice. And whereas he earned a PhD in theology from Boston University, and he daily lived his moral conviction of love and peace, he preached a gospel of nonviolence, and his commitment to make change through peace earned him the Nobel Peace Prize. And whereas each year his life, his dreams, and his achievements are commemorated in intercultural cooperation, uniting people of different cultural backgrounds on a day of celebration for all people everywhere. And whereas we are indebted to Dr. King for the sacrifices he made, he won great victories over prejudice, and his legacy will live on and inspire generations to come. Now, therefore, I, Tambra Vonador, on behalf of Shirley Groover Bryant, Mayor of the City of Palmetto, Florida, do hereby proclaim January 21st, 2013, as Martin Luther King Jr. Day in the City of Palmetto, Florida, and I call upon all citizens to use this opportunity to make a personal commitment to renew the dream and carry forward the vision of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Thank you.
For the occasion, Joan Crowder of the Bradenton Herald.
Good evening. The Bradenton Herald is honored to be a part of this celebration every year. Thank you very much on that. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. would have celebrated his 84th birthday this week, and despite his assassination more than four decades ago, his words still resonate. We still have so far to go to be a non-racist society where guns are silent, where peace reigns, where freedom is truly free. In Dr. King's most famous speeches, he foresees great social progress, rails against the evils of war, and warns that American freedoms guaranteed on paper are not granted to all. Our young essay writers certainly pick up on that every year in the Martin Luther King Essay Contest. This has become such an important part of this community's fabric. The best snapshot of this came when Mackenzie, a senior at Southeast High, took the stage to give her speech this year before the judges and thanked everyone for the opportunity. She's been taking that stage since she was in the eighth grade, building her character and resolve more and more every year. We must remember that we're here tonight for this next generation. We have the right and the responsibility to pass on Dr. King's dream to this generation. When Dr. King talked about his dream in 1963, that was just the start. We must work together to make that dream everyone's legacy. So here's to a grand evening.
At this time, it's my honor to introduce to you, I would call him an icon in our community. He's led Bell's department stores for years, and he's a board member of the Youth Center. Without the great support of the Bells family and the leadership at Bells, Steve Knoppick, you know, I was just talking to a good buddy of mine. He goes, Steve Knoppick has the coolest name. If you ever look at that name, it's really neat. I'm kid you not, that's what was said. But he really is an icon in our community, a behind-the-scenes kind of guy, mostly. But he runs one of our biggest businesses in the state of Florida. And he has helped guide the Youth Center through so much. If it wasn't for Steve Knoppick, I believe we wouldn't have the Youth Center we have today. So ladies and gentlemen, Steve Knoppick, please, of the Bells Department Store.
Thank you. You know, I've been involved at the Youth Center maybe for, I think, 15 years now or so, and over that time I've observed some amazing things, so I just wanted to kind of take a little walk down memory lane. You know, I remember seeing Governor Lawton Chiles, Senator Bob Graham, and Senator Bill Nelson all give keynote speeches at this banquet. I witnessed the completion of some important capital projects like the Bob and Aldana Bell Educational Wing and the Eddie Shannon Fieldhouse. I mourned with many of you the passing of Seymour Sales, who for so many years guided this center. And this year, another milestone, I cheered when Manatee County conveyed to the Palmetto Youth Center legal ownership of the land on which this center is built. You know, I'm very proud to serve on the board under the leadership of Ms. Frieda Bellamy, and I'm inspired by the commitment that this board has made to help the kids in the Palmetto community to live healthy and productive lives. For this board and staff, it's all about the kids, and that's why we're here tonight. And now for the things that I was called up to do as leader of our company. On behalf of the leadership and all the associates at Bell's, I'd like to publicly recognize and thank a few people. First, the Distribution Center leadership team, especially Rich Higgins, for all that they do for the Youth Center, not only tonight, but over the year. The team raised $22,000 in sponsorships and table sales for this event. Phenomenal job. And I'm especially thankful for the many vendors who have helped out over the years and have come to the banquet. There's a lot of Bell's vendors here that this is their fifth or sixth banquet. So thank you for all that you've done to help us. And I also want to thank Patricia Johnson. She's one of the stalwarts of the Palmetto Youth Center Board and the person who organizes and manages this entire MLK weekend. And I think most importantly, it's the speech contest that she's been the champion of that, for me, is always the highlight of the night. And finally, on behalf of Bob and Aldana Bell, I'd like to recognize several students who are attending college on scholarships from the Robert and Aldana Bell Family Foundation. As kids, these young adults participated in programs here at the center, and they competed for these scholarships through a pretty competitive application process, and they're now taking an important step in realizing their dreams. There's three who couldn't be here tonight: Quentin Peterson, Marquise Green, and Sidnisha Terrell. But there are also three who thankfully could be here tonight for us to recognize them in person. So please stand, and when I'm finished naming the three, we'll give them all a round of applause. Mariana Barbosa, Shanathan Martin, and Shaquelle Albritton. As I said, it's all about the kids for us at the board, and these kids are shining examples of what we're trying to produce here at the center, what we're trying to help this community to produce. The relationship that Bell's has formed and nurtured over the years with the Palmetto Youth Center is something that we believe enriches us as an organization, perhaps just as much or maybe even more than it helps the kids in this community. And for that, we are ever grateful. I would encourage each of you in this room who are in attendance tonight, to come out and visit us in the months ahead and learn how you can get involved and help some kids realize the rewards of a healthy and productive life. Thank you very much.
And thank you, Steve. Thank you, Bell's. When we think of the civil rights movement, what comes to mind are iconic images that we have grown over the years to see through either film or through television. Those images of Birmingham, of Selma, of Jackson, Charles Clapsaddle and Manatee Educational Television has put together a video or a film for us to put a little perspective in terms of film and video as to what this night is about and what the civil rights movement is about. So at this time, I'm going to ask Manatee Educational Television, Charles, if you would cue the tape, and I'd ask that you pay close attention to the screen.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Braden River High School and soon to be a Berklee College of Music in Boston, our former oratorical winner from last year, and you heard him sing a few minutes ago, Mr. Jordan Sanders is going to play a piece, but he said he's very grateful for the Youth Center for keeping the dream alive. Ladies and gentlemen, Jordan Sanders.
Okay, fortunately, I don't have to follow that. I think it's important to note that the song that he played resonates with all of us tonight, and it's actually symbolic of what we're going to have next. And that is the oratorical presentation, which has become a so familiar part of this celebration. And to introduce the oratorical presentation and the portion of the program in which we celebrate the spoken word and we celebrate the voice of freedom, I'd like Patricia Johnson to come forward, please.
Good evening. Let's get excited. Good evening. My name is Patricia Johnson, and I am the chairperson of the Oratorical Contest Committee. 2013 marks the 12th year that the Palmetto Youth Center has hosted this event. This year we received over 300 essays responding to the topic, Race, Are We Really So Different? The contest is comprised of a written and an oral component. The contest entries were evaluated based on how the student complied with the rules of the contest, how they addressed the topic, the effectiveness of the introduction and the conclusion, how innovative their approach to the topic was, and finally, how well they delivered their speech. This year's contestants delivered very personal stories that were well written, engaging, and insightful. I was encouraged by the students' passion, and I think that you will be entertained and inspired by the speeches you hear tonight. Before I present the contest winners, I would like to first thank our sponsors, the Bradenton Herald for advertising the event, Bell's and the Bradenton Herald for providing such wonderful gifts to our contestants, the Tillis Tutoring Center for providing the cash prizes, and especially Mrs. Tillis for working with the children to get them ready for their presentations tonight. I would also like to thank Blaylock Walters and CSNL for providing the computers and the printers that will be received tonight. I would like to now take this opportunity to recognize our judges, Frida Bellamy, Lily Covington, Reverend Ted Tillis, Reverend Stan Pakovich, and finally Joan from the Bradenton Herald. Can we give our sponsors and our judges a hand? Now on to our winners. As I call your name, please come forward. Our first winner is an honorable mention in the middle school category. His name is Benjamin Vera, and he's a seventh grade student at Nolan Middle School, and he will receive a cash prize of $50. Let's give him a hand. Unfortunately, he couldn't be here tonight, but I will get that check to him. Our third place recipient in the middle school category will receive a cash prize of $75. Our third place finalist is Miriam Schmoll. Come on, Miriam. Miriam is an eighth grade student at Sugg Middle School. Our second place winner in the middle school category is a sixth grader from Nolan Middle School, and it's Stevie Lee Romero. Stevie Lee will receive $100. And our grand prize winner in the middle school category will receive a brand new Dell laptop computer and printer and $150 in cash, we'll check. And that is Alex Kumar. Honorable mention in our high school category was Samantha Grimes. Samantha is a 10th grade student at Southeast High School. She will receive a cash prize of $50. Our third place winner in the high school category is a ninth grade student at Lakewood Ranch High School. She will receive a cash prize of $75, and her name is Molly Rainwater. Our second place student in the high school category is Mackenzie Urura. She actually participated in this contest as Joan said for since her eighth grade year, so 5 years, she will receive a cash prize of $100. And she could not be here today because she's out skiing, but she wanted to me to accept this on her behalf. And last but not least, our high school grand prize winner will receive, again, a brand new Dell laptop computer and printer and $150 in cash / check. And her name is Nathalie Kabongo-Chavez. Nathalie is a ninth grade student at Lakewood Ranch High School. Now, it's time to hear our children, and I'm so excited about this. I'm going to ask them to come forward and present their winning entries. You will first hear from Alex Kumar, and then immediately following him, you will hear from Nathalie. Alex?
Good evening. My name is Alex Kumar, and I'm a sixth grader at Nolan Middle School. What if I told you that I've agreed with what Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. stood for since I was 5 years old? When I was little, one of my favorite books by Dr. Seuss was called The Sneetches. You know the story about the star-belly Sneetches that acted like they were better than the plain-belly Sneetches. The star-belly Sneetches believed they were superior just because they were born with stars in their bellies. They taunted and discriminated against the plain-belly Sneetches because they were different. I remember thinking, what? How does having a star in your belly make anyone better or more privileged? This is so unfair. Later, when I learned about Dr. King in school, I realized that just like the plain-belly Sneetches, he and many African Americans were judged and treated unfairly. They were taunted and discriminated against for something so trivial, the color of their skin. Just like the plain belly Sneetches, many African Americans were not allowed to participate in games, refused opportunities, and faced segregation and discrimination everywhere they went. Dr. King was extremely hurt by the cruelty and injustice from people who judged him and his friends based solely off of their skin color and heritage, without even knowing the quality of their character. How could such blind injustice exist in our country that was built on freedom and equality? This harsh early experience shaped his dream for a better world, a world where all people are treated equally with the same rights of life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. As Dr. King once said, and I quote, "I look to a day when people will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character," unquote. Many people admire Dr. King for his vision, passion, dedication, integrity, and sense of right and wrong. I admire all of those things, but most of all, I admire Dr. King for his bravery. He dared to speak the truth in a time when it was extremely dangerous for him and his family. He was willing to sacrifice everything for what he believed in because he believed that, and I quote, "The day we see the truth and cease to speak is the day we begin to die," unquote. He knew he had to act and become the voice for the many people who wanted change but were too afraid to speak up. How could anyone be so courageous? Dr. King had the courage to speak up against racism because he was speaking the truth. All people had the same dream to be treated with respect and dignity. When I visited Washington, D.C. over Thanksgiving break, I saw Dr. King's memorial. His statue was rising out of a huge rock with the saying, "Out of the mountain of despair, a stone of hope." Dr. King was that stone of hope to everyone that believed in him. Even in the most desperate times, he pushed for change because deep in his heart, he had faith that the decency in people would allow them to change. He once said, and I quote, We must accept finite disappointment, but never lose infinite hope." Unquote. In the end, just like the Sneetches, we decided that no kind of person is better than another. People are people. Each one is equal. Dr. King said, and I quote, "We may have all come on different ships, but we're all in the same boat now," unquote. He also believed that we are all interrelated. He said, and I quote, "Whatever affects one directly affects all indirectly. I can never be what I ought to be until you are what you ought to be. This is the interrelated structure of reality," unquote. Dr. King has taught me that no matter what, we are all humans, and we must learn to live together peacefully. He also taught me that to make a difference, you must never lose hope, because hope is what gives you the courage to fight for what is right and just. Let's all remember, according to Dr. King, and I quote, "The time is always right to do what is right," unquote.
Good evening. My name is Nathalie Kabongo. I'm a ninth grade student at Lakewood Ranch High School, Bradenton, Florida. By now, I'm sure you all know that we are all humans. Some of us may think that although we are humans, we are different from each other. Are we really? Well, in some ways, we are. But there are times when we let that belief go too far. People are people. We live in different places, live different lives, and follow different beliefs. But we are still one big group, a group that thinks and acts very much alike. No matter where we are or where we come from, we all make mistakes. Hannah Montana once said, and I quote, "Nobody's perfect," unquote. Well, she's right. None of us are perfect. We have a way of thinking. We think about the same things, but in different ways. Everyone has feelings and opinions, the same by which we are all affected by. This, too, is a part of being us. Just why has race been such a huge problem in our world? We are confused by two words, different and difference. Such strong words, yet with simple meanings. To us, when something or someone is different, we think of them as being weird and unusual. If we see someone from a different country and we notice how different they speak and act, we will label them. Being different simply means not being the same as you. But no, it does not mean better than you or below you in any way. For people, it is normal to not welcome change as well as we wish we could. Our lives are based on routines. We talk to the same people most of the time. When someone new suddenly comes in the picture, our instinct is to point out their flaws because we do not understand who they are. We all need to open our world and welcome more change and diversity. Another thing that many of us have in common is that we follow others. When someone important in society speaks, we feel like we must agree. Sometimes we even let others decide our opinions. No one wants to be left out. We are afraid not to follow. But then, where are our leaders? We must accept our diversity. learn from others all the beauties that lie in culture. We must learn from each other's differences. That is what makes us alike. We must love each other. Of course, there will be times when we do not agree with the person sitting next to us. Let's face it, all of us have someone that we don't necessarily agree with at times. Through the character of Professor Albus Dumbledore, author J.K. Rowling once wrote, and I quote, "Though we may come from different places and speak in different tongues, our hearts beat as one," unquote. Most of all, we should remember that we are a family, and we must cherish the bond that holds us together. Imagine, for one moment, a box of crayons. Some are short and some are tall. There is a red one, a green one, and a blue one. We are that box of crayons. We come in different shapes, different sizes, and different colors. But all in all, we are made just the same.
That concludes our presentation. Weren't they wonderful?
Yes, they were.
Ladies and gentlemen, Jordan Sanders.
Thank you.
Thank you again, Jordan. And ladies and gentlemen, we're coming to the awards presentation portion of our program. And before we do that, in a few moments, you're about to see a video tribute to a great person. We lost one of the greatest people to ever grace this area recently, and that is former Senator Edgar H. Price, Jr. You could describe Senator Price in many different ways. You could call him a politician because he was a senator, state senator, a businessman because he was a very successful businessman. And you could also call him a war hero, although he never talked about it, he was. He really was a member of the greatest generation in that respect. But I think the best word that describes Senator Price is what we name an award for him, and that is humanitarian. One of the things that Manatee Educational Television does is chronicle history, and they chronicle the history of people who have made a significant impact in this community. And with the help of Manatee Educational Television and Charles Clapsaddle and his team, before we get to the actual award presentations, they are going to present to you a video tribute of one of the greatest men to ever grace this area, Senator Edgar Price. And if you would pay close attention to the screens, you may start the film. Thank you, Charles. At this time, we're going to present our awards, and per our tradition, the presenters of the awards will be shown on the screens to my left and right. We are going to start by having someone introduce the recipient of the Edgar H. Price Humanitarian Award, Mr. Walter Prochet. So I'd ask that you pay close attention to the screens.
It is my honor to introduce Charles Smith as the 2013 recipient of the Edgar H. Price Humanitarian Award. As you all know, Senator Price passed away in early December. He was an amazing man, mentor, and friend who I miss. I believe Senator Price would have been happy that this award is being presented to Commissioner Smith. Charles is Mr. Palmetto, for he supports and continues to work to strengthen our community bonds. Anytime you attend a community family event, you will see Charles working behind the scenes. Charles continues to serve Ward 1 of Palmetto's Commission, which he was appointed to following the retirement of Mary Lancaster and after recently winning his re-election in November. Although Charles was born in Batavia, New York, he grew up in Palmetto and learned his work ethic from his father, who owns the family business, Manatee Harvesting Company, which continues this tradition today. Charles graduated from Palmetto High School and received his bachelor's in criminology at the University of Central Florida. After graduating from college, he came back to his hometown and joined his father's company, helping it to become the successful business it is today. Charles also owns his own investigations and bail bond company, Smith and Smith Bail Bond. He has tackled the family business, secured investigations, and his bail bond certification work, all with positive results. Charles has shown outstanding initiative and loves Palmetto and Manatee County. He has been involved in the Palmetto Multicultural Festival, which has been a very successful event. Charles has been focused on bringing our children safe places to learn and play. He is dedicated to bring our community the $1 million Martin Luther King Jr. Park, which will be built in 2013 behind the Palmetto Center facility. Charles fought for funding to hire the first black female officer in the history of the city of Palmetto. Commissioner Smith has tackled the complex issues of housing citizens in a rough economic time. He led a petition to establish the first ever housing authority in the city of Palmetto. He has led the effort for a partnership with Habitat for Humanities, a Brush for Kindness housing program. Through the years, Charles has led the effort to partner with the Palmetto Youth Center to seek and acquire better funding. Charles doesn't help people to earn political clout. Charles serves his community because of his own moral ethics and strong Christian values. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s principles of leadership include having a vision, effective communication, willingness to learn, willingness to lead, and conflict resolution. Charles has all of these qualities, and his success as a leader derives from his strong work ethic, keen intellect, engaging personality and sense of humor, eternal optimism, and faith in God. Congratulations, Charles, on receiving the 2013 Ed H. Price Humanitarian Award. We all know that the best is yet to come from you and your service to this community.
Thank you so much, Mr. Walter Prochet. It's such an honor to be here tonight. For so many people here tonight with this wonderful event, I am so very humbled to be here. I have thought many of times of most of you here that I haven't seen in a while. What a great occasion. I would like to thank the committee who seemed fit to recommend me for such an honor award. The Palmetto Youth Center Board of Directors, who also participated and recommended me for such a humanitarian award. I didn't get here by myself. A lot of you out there have supported me over the years through tough times. I would like to thank the Vice Mayor of Palmetto, Commissioner Vonador to my left, who's my classmate, who's been very supportive of me over the years, to Commissioner Jonathan Davis, who's next to her, who have supported me and allowed me to vent and articulate what we need for this community. I am so proud to be here. I was supposed to be in Washington, D.C. this weekend. When I was contacted by the Executive Director of the Palmetto Youth Center, Mr. Lekowiak, that they had recommended me to receive this award, I was so surprised, but I was honored. Over the years, I have served with many ministers, and I consider to serve today. On the National Board of SCLC, I have 38 ministers that I work with. A year ago, they appointed me as the National Compliance Chairman, personally overseeing 400 chapters in compliance issues. In my wildest dreams, on this special occasion, with our co-founder, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., I have never thought I would be here tonight. What an occasion to celebrate our co-founder, celebration here tonight because of what he stood for and all the elected officials there who stood for the same principle that he stood. I have walked through the streets of Sanford, Florida, New Orleans, Savannah, Georgia, Atlanta, Pensacola, with civil rights leaders all over America, from conservative to the organization of Billy Graham to Reverend Al Sharpton, where I serve on the board of directors. I have worked with Andrew Young and heading to Birmingham, Alabama next week to meet with him. But one of the most important walks I've done was when I was first elected in 1990 as the first black city councilman at that time to the Palmetto City Council. This walk and all the walks I just mentioned never touched this walk. Because when I first was elected, I was contacted by this time Representative Boyd, who at the time served on the Palmetto City Council at that time with me. He phoned me and said, "Councilman Smith, I need you to meet me tomorrow." I said, "Councilman Boyd, what's going on?" He said, "Do you know Lawton Childs?" I said, "Yeah, I know he's running for governor." He said, "Do you know Senator Edgar H. Price?" I said, "Yes, absolutely." He said, "Well, they're coming to Palmetto, and they want to walk Saturday, and they want to walk in East Palmetto." Well, when he told me that, I was concerned. I was not happy about the conditions of East Palmetto. Understand, we had houses 30 by 20 that I was ashamed of. I hadn't even took the oath of office at that time. But I told Councilman Boyd, "What time you want me there?" He said, "They're going to be there at 10 a.m. We met on 2nd Avenue in East Palmetto at 10 a.m. As I looked to my right, it was a whole group of people coming in vans. They pulled up to 2nd Avenue. I had about 50 people waiting for them to arrive. As they pulled up, Lawton Childs got out. Senator Price got out. They stepped out and shook my hand. And I say, "I'm glad to meet you." Governor Childs said, "I want to walk through this community because we're going to change this community. There's not a better community I should be to, but this community. I know what's going on in the rest of the community, but I need to be here." They got out their vehicles with about 50 reporters following them. As you know, he was on the ballot in November that year. And they said, "We want to walk through this community and shake and knock on doors. We need to do it for 10 minutes. As they started walking, if you knew how they walked, they had this walk about themselves. I mean, if you know how they walk, Lawton Childs, who walked across the state of Florida, Senator Edward Price, who was walking with him, they had this stride about themselves, and the reporter was running, trying to stay with them. As they walked and knocked on doors, Senator Price looked to me and said, "You the first black city councilman in Palmetto?" I said, "That's correct." He looked over to Governor Childs, and Senator Price say, "I know, Governor. We got a lot of work to do." And from that point on, I have been friends of the family and him. It's such an honor to receive this award in his name, and I don't take it lightly, because a lot of you here got me here. There's a lot of you supported me. There's a lot of you prayed for me. There's a lot of you encouraged me. There's a lot of you say, don't give up. There's a lot of you say, run, Charles, run. I had faith to run, I didn't give up. And guess what? The Palmetto City Commission had a vacancy and seemed fit to trust me and appointed me to that seat, and I'm humbly grateful that they did. Allow me to say this to you as I take my seat. No matter what you do in life, no matter what they say you can't do, no matter how old you are or how sick you are, until God give up on you, you still in the fight. Until this situation was taking place in your life, no matter what you came from. Some have said, I will never be a publisher to Braden Harrell. Some have said, I will never be an educator. Some have said, I'll never be in law enforcement. Some have said, I've never been ordained minister. Some have said, I will never be an ordained deacon. Don't allow anyone to tell you, no matter what, that you can't do it. Because some told me. I just want to take my hat off to all of you, some that I may not see tonight, to my family, my mother and my father, Robert Smith Jr. and Rosa Smith Jr., who have stood by my side for many years, to tough times. And let me share this with you as I take my seat, because I believe this is something that may help you, because I believe in speaking truth. There have been some dark times in my life, and I remember that I was so broke, didn't have any money, didn't know where my next meal would come from, and was a grown man on my mother's floor counting pennies. And God has delivered me through you, who have prayed for me and stood by me. And I want to thank you so much for this award. God bless you.
And now for the Louise Johnson Humanitarian Award, Mr. Larry Newsom, please take a look at the screen, please.
Hello, my name is Larry Newsom. I am honored and delighted to introduce a person near and dear to me, my sister Shirley Pearson. Shirley is one of eight children born to the late Reverend Moses and Rosalie Newsom. She was raised in Palmetto, Florida, and attended Lincoln Memorial High School. Upon marriage to Moses Pearson, she moved to Wichita, Kansas, where she lived for 42 years. She has one daughter, Brenda, and four grandchildren, Brian, Stacy, Aaron, and Anaya. Shirley earned a Bachelor of Science degree in Human Resources and a Master's degree of Science in Business Management from Friends University in Wichita, Kansas. Shirley has always had a passion for community services. She worked with many community organizations in Wichita. She led several United Way campaigns for her employer. While in Wichita, Shirley worked 24 years for Boeing Aircraft Company as a manufacturing engineer, teaching new processes and working with airplane emergencies all over the world. She retired in 2004. Shortly after retirement, Shirley moved back to Palmetto, where she became actively involved in developing Mount Carmel Community Resource Center, a 501c3 nonprofit organization. The center has set up many working community partnerships, such as Manatee Technical Institute, Meals on Wheels, the Food Bank, Suncoast Workforce, Mayor's Feed the Hungry program, the North River Project, the Palmetto Police Department, and many other resources that benefit the clients of Mount Carmel. Shirley's goal is to continue working with other organizations for community enhancement. Our family, as well as Mount Karma, feel a deep sense of gratitude that Shirley is being honored for her hard work and compassion. Congratulations, Shirley, on a well-deserved honor.
Thank you, bro, for that presentation. Thank you so much. I love you. Okay, I'd like to start by saying a very, very special thank you to Mr. Chris LaCorrick and the Palmetto Youth Center Board of Directors for this honor. I would also, secondly, like to take the time to say thank you to a few people who helped to make tonight a possibility for me. I would like to start with saying to share this honor with my team of volunteers at our center. These ladies are the best in America, okay, that I work with each day. They're Joyce Dukes, Vivian Williams, Joyce Williams, and Susie Davis. Susie is sick right now, so she can't help us as much, but I still thank her for her help and her support that she gives us at the center. I would like to say a special thank you to these ladies for your hard work each day and giving of yourselves for our community. I would also like to say thank you to my husband, Moses, my grandson, Brian, who's here from New York, sharing with me tonight, all of my sisters and brothers for your continued love and support. Table 44. All right. Okay, I would also like to say special thank you to Mount Carmel Baptist Church and Pastor Alpha James for being a very proactive pastor in our community that has supported having our community resource center open to get out there and to help people every day. So I thank him for that and also our church. And also, I would like to take this time to say special thank you to Chief Wells over here and the Palmetto Police Department for all that you do year-round to support our center. Your donations of bicycles, TVs, clothing to our clients is a major help. The bicycles are the only transportation some of our clients know, and they've given us like about 30 bicycles in the last 6 months. So I can't begin to tell you the joy on our clients' face when they get those bicycles because this is all they have. So we thank you, Chief, for all of your help and everything that the police department does for us. And not only that, but I want to say thank you for helping me to set up the schools and churches in Palmetto to collect food for Mass Feed the Hungry program. Not only do you help me set up the food collection, but you go back to the schools and churches and help to pick up that food. And this is the food that we give out at Thanksgiving and Christmas time. This is our police department, guys, that's out there really into our community helping us. And I just thought you should know that. So, and I appreciate them for doing all of that. And also, we're in the process of developing and expanding our community safety meetings with our Palmetto Police Department as well, and our Sheriff Department. These meetings will involve getting pastors and their memberships working together, getting them involved in the community to help our law enforcement. This is called coming together. We're gonna have more on that coming real soon on these meetings, so look out for it, community. Thanks again, Chief Wells and the Palmetto Police Department for everything you do, Chief. Okay, and I wanna say thank you to Chief Jeff Burden and Palmetto CRA, he's the director there and his staff. Mayor Bryant, Palmetto City Commissioners for your years of continued help and support for our center. Your help is greatly appreciated. And they don't just come, you know, for a few photo ops. The mayor and the commissioners and the police department, they've been coming for years now. to help us at our center, and that is so, so much appreciated. Also, I would like to say thank you to my friend over there, Debbie DeLeon. She's from Neighborhood Services. You're always there, Debbie, no matter what project that the center is doing. And you're always there, a phone call away. And I mean, you just, okay, Shirley, I'm on my way. So I thank you, Debbie, for all of your help and your support as well, okay? Success comes when we as a community leaders and our community come together and work for a common goal and for a community enhancement. It does come when we work together and not just going our separate ways, but when we work together. I want to quote one thing from Joyce Myers, and I know a lot of you do know Joyce Myers. Our lives are a louder sermon than anything we say. I'm going to repeat that one. Our lives are a louder sermon than anything that we say. I agree with her 500% there. So on behalf of myself and my team of ladies and my church, Mount Carmel Baptist Church, we say thank you for this honor.
At this time, to present the winner of the Small Business Owner Award, Mr. Steve Arvey. So please look at the screen.
Hi, my name is Steve Arvey, local musician and comedian. It is my honor and privilege to introduce the recipients of this year's Small Business Award, Joe and Veronica Forney, the owners of Kojak's Palmetto Rib House and Barbecue. Not only has Kojak's been one of the best places to eat for years in Manatee County, they have also provided a great atmosphere featuring many local musicians and raising money from many local charities. They have reached out into the community and have helped many people throughout the years. Here's to you, Joe and Veronica, and the whole staff of Kojak's.
Joe and Veronica could not be here tonight. I'm going to ask Chris Lakowiak to come and take the award in their honor.
Thanks. Joe and Veronica called about 6:45. They had a situation in their kitchen this evening. They apologized that they're not going to be here, but they said everybody stop down there on the way home. They could use the business. Thank you.
Now for the Outstanding Citizenship Award, we have Karen Windham to present. If you could, attention to the screen.
It is my pleasure and honor to introduce the Structural Maintenance and Repair Team, better known as the SMART Team. The SMART Team was formed just over a year ago and is a goal-oriented and proactive group. The concept was to better manage and protect our public facilities and create a system to move forward from preventive maintenance to predictive maintenance. Property Management Director Charlie Bishop advocated for the SMART Team's development and has been a tireless leader in ensuring that the team provides the greatest value possible. After a visit to the Youth Center, Charlie called in the SMART Team to make some much-needed improvements. The team, consisting of Eric Angersoll, Building Trades Supervisor, and Building Trades Workers Casey Turner, Gary Phillips, Travis Green, and Chris Spriggs. The concept was based on an Air Force model consisting of a 5-member team with carpentry, electric, HVAC, plumbing, and painting skills. No facility is too large or too small for the team to handle. The team moves from facility to facility on a schedule, inspecting, repairing, and maintaining county facilities. Typically, spending 1 to 2 weeks at each location, they identify needs, issues, wants, and evaluate what can be accomplished both from a structural and an aesthetic perspective. This year, the team visited over 22 sites ranging from libraries to parks and included this great project at the Palmetto Youth Center. The renovations at the Palmetto Youth Center took over 380 man hours and $4,800 to complete. The team repaired ramps leading into the classrooms. They painted rooms. They repaired doors to enhance both energy savings and security, and replaced light fixtures and thermostats to reduce the electric bill. The team also did outside work, which included painting, removal of dead trees, landscaping, and numerous exterior repairs. Palmetto Youth Center has provided so much to the children of this community, and it was an honor for the team to be able to give back to this valued organization. This SMART team is amazing, and they so deserve this Outstanding Citizen Award. We appreciate the recognition of their work and their opportunity to serve. Thank you.
The Manatee County SMART Team.
Thank you. Ed, commissioners of Manatee County, Eric's been in the five libraries in Manatee County for the last month and a half, and they're going to expect this about every quarter. Yeah. No, it's we're truly humbled and honored that we received this award. We can't thank Chris Lukowiak enough, but truly the stage isn't big enough for just the five members of the SMART team. Recognition needs to go out to Tina Neri, our United Way coordinator for Manatee County. It was her that reached out initially and saw this project as a need. She reached out to me and my team, and we rallied around her. The day of caring came and went, and then we actually had a little bit of support with our 12th Street crew, Reed Coffey, Bernie, Ken Rear, Bruce Larson. They too supported this. But it was Eric's team that stayed. They were here first, and they were the last ones to leave. And we were truly honored and proud of what we accomplished. And the SMART team, I can't be more proud of you. Thank you.
Our last award of the evening goes to someone who's the son of a very dear friend of mine and a former colleague, but I'm not going to give it away quite yet. At this time, to introduce the recipient of the government award, please pay close attention to the screen to Mr. Jay Thomas.
I met Mr. Gallen on a cruise ship going to Cozumel, Mexico. Didn't even know who this gentleman was. All I knew, he was a guy about my stature, and he was wearing a fedora hat, and I was wearing a fedora hat. We began to have a conversation, and I said, "Hey, don't I know you from somewhere?" And he says, "Yes, I'm Michael Gallen." And there I was on a cruise ship with Michael Gallen. Should have been only probably a minute conversation. It turned out to be like an hour and a half conversation. And that's when I began to realize how detailed Mr. Gallen was. We talked about our community, talked about being from Manatee County. He told me his concerns about his community. When we got back from the cruise, 2 days later, I saw Mr. Gallen driving around in my community and looking up the things and looking into the concerns that we had about our community. He was driving his white minivan with car seats in it. And that's when I realized this man is very serious about his community. The first thing I've noticed about Mr. Gallen is that he's a godly man. Second thing is that he's a family man. He's always involved with his family, Mrs. Gallen, and his girls and his one son, which is Thomas. Wherever he goes, his children normally goes. When we have community meetings, he brings them along. And number three is that this man is a fighter. He told me a story about fighting cancer. Realizing all these things that I've dealt with him for a whole year, I realized that this man is very serious about his community. He's a mover and shaker, and it's been a privilege to be able to engage with Mr. Gallen. And congratulations on this award that you're receiving.
Well, I told CJ I would put some diversity here and say buenas noches a todos to my friends in the audience and everyone tonight. I am honored for this recognition. It's something I didn't expect, and I want to thank the Palmetto Youth Center and the board for recognizing me for this government award. This award does hold a special place in my heart, and that my father stood up here not too long ago, and he received an award from the same board, and he's my role model and continues to be my role model. He's sitting in the back of the room tonight, so I appreciate him being here tonight and seeing this. There's a number of people that I need to thank real quick, and I'll keep this short. I know it's been an evening here, but first want to introduce mi esposa, bonita, inteligente, my beautiful, intelligent wife, Alexandra, over here to my right. She laughs when I speak Spanish, so I figured I would. She puts up with me coming home after a long day of work and then leaving for an evening of work. It takes someone special to deal with that. So she has been able to put up with that. And I also want to thank my mom and dad who are here tonight. It's special that they're here. As regular babysitters they are, except for tonight. And we had to pull some money out of our pocket tonight. I need to thank them for giving me an upbringing where I've, instilling compassion for others and instilling a civic duty to my community. And only they could do that. They did it right, I think. So they're the most supportive and perfect parents anyone can ask for, I have to say. I'd also need to thank Manatee County staff. Many of them have been mentioned here tonight. They're out in the audience. They make me look good, whenever I can pick up the phone and call someone within 24 hours, the issue's resolved. So our staff is wonderful. My fellow commissioners are here tonight. I need to thank them. This couldn't be done without their support. This is truly a team effort here. It's also very important that I thank you all in the audience. That this community is something special. This is a proactive community. This is a very special community that isn't afraid to speak out when there's an issue. And that's what makes my job easier, because you do speak out. You're a close-knit community. But not only do you speak out, but you provide assistance to get things done, to resolve the issue, to rectify the situation. And there are so many partners out there, so many familiar faces, so many City of Palmetto, Palmetto Police Department, so many service organizations and businesses in the community that really step up and get it done. And that's who this needs to go out to. It's not me. Our government, yes, is performing, but it's our community. It's you all getting it done. And there's hundreds of Martin Luther King quotes out there, Martin Luther King Jr. quotes out there. Our fine young students presented them well tonight. And one that rung to me most tonight and most relevant tonight was when he said, life's most urgent question is, what are you doing for others? And everyone in this audience, everyone who's here tonight, everyone up here to my left, to my right, Chris, the Palmetto Youth Center, you guys do so much for others. So I just want to commend you for that, and that's why I'm here tonight, because you do so much for others. One last note, just to demonstrate how quick and proactive you all are in our community is, I was elected and I took office. I didn't slept a whole night in bed when I got a phone call from Pastor Livingston. He said, Mr. Gallen, you ever heard of the 88 acres? And to this day, I'm carrying the 88 acres like a football, and I'm not going to drop it. So, I want to thank you all for helping others and being who you are. Thank you very much.
Commissioner Gallen has always been a great help to the Youth Center. Thank you very much, sir. You are truly a rare leader. Thank you. And now, our leader in our community, in the Palmetto Youth Center community, our executive director, Chris Lukowiak.
I'm gonna get my cheaters. You know, I went to the eye doctor about 6 months ago, and he said, everything's fine. He said, next time you come in, let me know what prescription your cheaters are. I said, I don't wear cheaters. He said, oh, you will pretty soon. A week later, I had to go get them. So just so you know, when your doctor tells you that, just go buy a pair, give in. I'm gonna try and make it quick. I got a lot of people to thank. First, I want to acknowledge my board. My board works tirelessly. You know, we meet officially once a month, but I can tell you I'm on the phone and emailing them and driving them nuts daily, it seems, especially this time of year. So as I say your name, would you please stand up? And then at the end, we'll clap for all of them to keep things moving. Frida Bellamy, please stand up. Thank you. Reggie Bellamy can't be here today. He's at a basketball game. Miss Covington, Lily Covington, please remain standing. Frankie Craddock, CJ Zaya, Ed Dick, Patricia Johnson, Steve Knoppick, that is a cool name, Aura Lee Murray, Coach Shannon, Reverend Tillis, Judge Williams, Reverend Stan, and Elston Brown, I don't believe is here today. I did not see him. Let's have a round of applause for my board, please. Thank you. I want to thank METV and Charles Clapsaddle for all they do. You know, this is a diamond in the rough here. I was just thinking about how lucky we are in Manatee County. I'm going to get into that in a second. But, you know, Charles and I are dancing for about 4 or 5 months leading up to this thing. Get the recordings done, the reels that are playing, you know, all evening. And, I mean, just everything. They've been here since probably about 1 o'clock this afternoon, just working right through getting things up and running. And I'm not clear on who METV reports to or gets budgeted from, but whatever government body that is here in this county, please keep them strong and whole. Thank you. Okay, my staff. My staff is spread out throughout the room here. I have a great staff. I have a staff with my two key people, Brenda Bell, my child care director, and Tony Stevens, my athletic director. Have close to between the two of them about 40 years here. Every good boss knows, every good leader knows, it's the people under you that make you. And they make me. They, my job's easy with people like that, and that's the truth. You know, I'd love to take some more credit, but I can't. I won't be able to sleep tonight. So Tony, Brenda, and the rest of my staff here, thank you very much. We appreciate it. I want to thank the parents of my kids, and we call them our kids, and we know them by a first name basis. This is not a factory by any means. We are very close with all of our children here. You can see pictures on the walls. The kids that come to our before and after school programs, our athletics. Our girls went, I believe, fifth in the nation again. Is that correct, Tony? Fifth in the nation this year again, our cheer and dance team. Girls are fabulous. But, you know, I want to thank the parents because the parents put their faith in us. You know, I have children. I have grandchildren. My granddaughter comes here. And I know it's a big deal. You know, and I can't thank the parents enough for that, for having that trust. And I will tell you that with every ounce of energy I have in my heart and soul, we will continue to do the best job we can and keep your children safe. You know, because of the Manatee County Smart Team, we have all new doors and locking mechanisms and different things in place, you know, to add to that safety factor. So please, if you are a parent out there, thank you. If you know a parent of a child that comes here, tell them I said thank you. We really appreciate it and wouldn't be here without them. So thanks. All right, on to the business at hand here. Manatee County. Manatee County is responsible for about 60% of our budget. Steve mentioned earlier that we've worked with the county administrator and the county commission and staff, property management, Charlie and a few other folks, and we now own the land on which these buildings sit on. It's a big deal. And I'd be remiss if in saying that we don't acknowledge Blaylock and Walters. Will Robinson from Blaylock and Walters, Will, stand up for a minute, please. Pro bono, I don't know, probably to the tune of $5,000, $6,000, $8,000, $10,000, whatever it was, pro bono, didn't charge us a dime, took care of everything. And I mean, I can't thank him enough. Thank you. Thank you. I appreciate it. Manatee County, I can say this. I believe that we, the residents of Manatee County, are lucky enough to have the best, in the years I've been around here, the best board that has been assembled to date of Manatee County commissioners and directors. Let's give them a clap at the hand. This group is taking us places. Just stand back. Let's get out of their way. Let them do their thing. They're taking us places. And with that, we got to work to keep Ed here. Ed, I see you back there. Don't get mad at me. I had to say it. It may be my only opportunity. So thank you, commissioners, staff from Manatee County. I want to thank United Way. They also give us about a 10% of our budget, and we're grateful for them. When I talk about how lucky we are in Manatee County, we here, especially in Palmetto, we have the best sheriff, I believe, in the state, maybe in the country. I don't know anymore. Sheriff Stubbe, thank you, as always. And here in Palmetto, we're double lucky because we got Chief Wells, and he's a great man. And if you haven't met him, you need to introduce yourself. And one day, we don't have the time today, but one day we are going to have him come in and do the Can't Touch This dance. I don't know if any of you seen it, but I did. It's amazing. It's amazing. We got to get him in here. I want to thank the honorees. You know, the Brandon Harrell asked me today, I think it was Brandon Harrell, asked me today, why do you honor these folks? You know, why them? Why not somebody else? How do you get to that? And I went through the process, the official paperwork that we do as a board and how we go about it. But, you know, my answer to them was, the reason why we honor folks like this is because these are folks that are doing things for this community, for our children, for the community, for adults, for everyone, black, white, whatever, doesn't matter. And they're not seeking recognition for what they're doing. That's why we recognize them, because they're doing it from the heart. You know, and that, it, to my opinion, makes everyone up here special. And I want to thank you all again for that, for giving us the opportunity. Please support our sponsors up on the wall and in the program. These folks have been with us for a long time. They continue to be supporters of ours. I'm going to close with two things. I want to thank God. Without him, none of this would be possible. Let's give him a hand. He always gives us here at the Youth Center what we need. We may not always get what we want, but we get what we need. So let's keep praying. And last but not least, if you take anything from here tonight, anything that I've said or that anyone says, shop at Bell's. Thank you. Sorry, with that, I'd like to bring up Pastor Stan to close us out, to bring us home.
Thank you, Chris. It's been a very inspiring, rich night, I think you would agree. You know, when you hear the news and read the news, watch it on TV, You always see him being bombarded by the negative people are doing. And just, it's refreshing tonight just to celebrate the good that people are doing in our community. So I'm leaving here very refreshed and energized, and thank you guys for all that you do in our community. Let's just bow our heads and pray right now. Father, we thank you, God, for tonight that we could come together and celebrate and remember the legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King, God. We thank you, God, for how far our country has come. We also recognize that there's continued injustices in our country and around the world. And I pray for each one of us here tonight that we would continue to be agents of change, God, that we would respond correctly in a way that would honor you, and that we would always look to make a difference in those that we influence around us. And we thank you, and I pray a blessing upon each person, each family represented here tonight. We pray these things in the all-powerful name of Jesus Christ. Amen. God bless. Amen.